So basically, what is the purpose of VPNs? We use VPN for secure communications over internet or over public network or over untrust network. Okay. So if we have this diagram, so this is our inside network or head office network, and this is our branch office network. Okay. So the thing is, these users try to connect with these users always for some business reasons, and they connect always through the internet. In that internet is unsecure. Everyone like launch the attack, or they can sniff our traffic, they can just tamper our traffic, they can do anything with the data. Okay, and let's suppose these are the like banking office. Let's suppose this is a head office of a bank, this is a branch office of a bank. Okay, so in head office basically journey all the servers is available. And so the thing is, let's suppose this is a user in a branch office. So when he do the any transaction, so he need to access the servers. Okay, so for if he access these servers in a like clear text mode or in a like plain internet, there is they without any security. So the thing is, anyone snip that traffic, or he can also traffic the tamper that data, or he just add some malicious things over there. Okay, and he can also like extract the confidential information from that transaction. Okay, so to get the like security for this kind of data, we need a VPN. So what happens? We create one VPN tunnel from this. This is our firewall. This firewall to this firewall. Okay, I will tell you what kind of, so generally what kind of encryption mechanism, what kind of hashing mechanism we use. Okay, so if we have a like, this is our remote office, this is our firewall, or we can see the thing is, this is maybe in old days what happens, we use a one particular device for VPNs, which is known as VPN concentrator. Okay, but the thing is, after that what happens, Cisco just purchased this company VPN concentrator, and the feature of VPN concentrator they put with the PIX firewall, and they make a Cisco ASA firewall. Okay, so Cisco ASA firewall is a mixture of VPN concentrator box and the PIX box. PIX is a like very old firewall from Cisco, which does only the ACL net, that kind of things. Okay, and these are the like servers which are available in our head office DMZ network. Okay, and these are the other servers. So the thing is, if anyone from remote office trying to go to this network or these network trying to reach to this network, they need a some kind of like encryption mechanism, right? Some kind of security. So we can provide this security using VPNs. So VPN basically use a protocol which is IPsec VPN. It's not a protocol, it's a like combination of some protocols. Okay, which like basically which provide a framework to create a VPN tunnels. Okay. Authentication. Do you know what is the meaning of authentication? Authentication means if we have our mobile devices, right, a mobile phone, there basically generally we set the fingerprint there as a lock. We can also some configure some pass, some pin code there. So if we put the like right pin code, that is the like authentication. Okay. Or we can also take best example is a ATM. For that we have always we enter a pin number there. So if the pin is correct, then we are authenticating that. We are authenticating this card. Okay. That is the meaning of authentication, right? We are just communicating with the right guy or not. That is also a like meaning of authentication in case of VPN. Integrity. Integrity means our data is, see the thing is, when we send some data, okay, we need the integrity on that. Means no one just tamper our data, no one add something on that data, or if somebody like remove something from that particular data. Okay, so that is the feature of integrity. we can achieve integrity by using the hashing mechanism. Like we have some hashing mechanism like MD5, SHA-1, SHA-1, SHA-120, SHA-256, that kind of flavor. Okay, an unbroken back seal on an envelope ensures integrity. Means if we got a card, okay, with a seal which is not broken from anywhere, means our data is secured. That is the meaning of integrity. Okay. The unique unbroken seal ensures no one has read the contents. Confidentiality. See, the thing is that confidentiality means encryption. See, if my name is like something, so let me take this word. This is a Julius, okay? Or we can say, let me open the notepad first. I will show you there. Let's take this. This is my mobile number, okay? Let's suppose. So what happens? Confidentiality means I'll take these two words, okay? After it I write 8, 9. Okay, so here what happens, I'll take these word only 8 and I'll put there. My system is slow, but not sure. Okay, after that I'll 8, 9, 8. Okay, so I just change the format. Okay, if we have a like something, someone name is start from like this one, Raj. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll put in place of R, I'll use something else. We can use like S, then in place of A we use the B, in place of J we use the I. Okay, so it means I am changing. I'll just go like one word above. So what means, if I want to decode this one, I'll just consider the all the word which is like for S, I'll take the R because S R comes before the S come, okay, in alphabetical form. So that is the way we are just changing our content from one form to another form. Julius Caesar would send encrypted message to his generals in the battlefield. That is the from there basically this that kind of things started. Okay. Even if intercepted, his enemies usually could not read, let alone decipher the message. Generally, that time what happened? That word basically, that confidentiality also known as a cipher. Caesar cipher something name. Okay, if you like read the history of that, what kind of encryption mechanism we have. Okay, that's the confidentiality. We are just changing word in a some other form. History, that's not a like something. Transposition of ciphers. Okay, so generally we can just change the name like this. That is the like history of these ciphers, how we can create a cipher. So let me skip these cipher things from here. Okay, that is important. Man in the middle attack. Okay, what happens if we send some data from this user to this user without any encryption? If someone is sitting here, okay, and he is just watching our data, so man in the middle attack means maybe that guy adds some thing on that data, or he remove something from the data, or maybe he change all the data. Okay, that is the like meaning of man in the middle. Authentication and authorization. See, actually authentication means we are just, if when we log in into the firewall, okay, so when we put our right credential like username and password, so that time our firewall is authenticate us. Okay, so that is the authentication. We got the access of that particular device, that is the authentication. And authorization means what kind of access we have on that device. Okay, so basically level of our access on a particular thing, it is a authorization. Okay, what kind of authorization we have in a company. Like in a company, if your team lead have a like more access than you, okay, that is the like authentication, authorization. That is clear. I'll need to take some more example on that authentication, authorization. Okay, cool. See, man in the middle attack, that is the only the man in the middle attack. Okay, maybe they explain in a little bit like they are using keys, that kind of things. Okay, I don't want to go in that much deeper because otherwise all things go out of that head. So that is not a good diagram also. Yeah, that's a nice. See, generally what happens for integrity, we have a MD5 algorithm and SHA algorithm. Okay, it's create a hash value. Okay, for authentication we use that HMAC MD5, HMAC SHA-1, RSA and DSA. Okay, for confidentiality we have a mechanism like DES, 3DES. Like DES is only 56 bit long encryption. Okay, it's like 3 time of 56. After we have a AES and we have a SEAL. Generally right nowadays we are using these ones. Secure one is a AES, and in integrity we always use the SHA-1. So confidentiality we achieve by using encryption. Integrity we achieve by using hash. Authentication we achieve by using the certificates or pre-shared key. Okay, remember this thing. So VPN also provides the CIA, these three things. CIA means confidentiality, integrity, authenticity. These three terms. Okay, these are the like similar. CIA. Hashing basics. Hashes are used for integrity assurance. Hashes are based on one-way functions. Means if we hash our data in some other format, okay, then there is no way for the reverse engineering. We can't like get back this hash value. Okay, that is the meaning of hash. Hash function hashes arbitrary data into a fixed length digest known as the hash value, message digest or a fingerprints. Okay, these are the three things. So it's a like it, that data is looks like in such a way. We have like in MD5 we get around 64 bit hash. In SHA-1 we get a 28 bit head hash value. In SHA-256 we get a 256 byte hash value. Okay, these are the hashing properties. So leave this thing, hashing in action. Yeah, MD5 is a hashing algorithm. Hashing properties, one way function, easy to compute hash and infeasible to compute the data given a hash. Okay, complex sequence of simple binary operation. Generally what happens nowadays, we have a reverse engineering for MD5 hash. That's why people use the SHA-1, SHA-256, that kind of hashing mechanism. SHA is a similar design to the MD4 and MD5 family of the hash mechanism. Takes an input message of number more than 2 into 64 bits, produce a 160-bit message digest. Okay. So we have a different form of hash like SHA-224, SHA-256. SHA-384, that kind of things. Okay. Hashing example, like this is our text. Okay. If we generate a hash for this text, it looks like in such a way. Okay. So let me skip some slides. Yeah, symmetric key encryption. Okay, symmetric encryption. Symmetric encryption means what happened? We have a same key for encrypt the data and same key for decrypt the data. Means if we have one lock, so we are using same key to lock that lock and unlock that lock. Okay. Or that symmetric encryption is a preset key. Means this key we need to also share with the other guy. Okay. Best known as a preset key algorithm. We use in our IPsec VPN, we use that preset key. Okay. The usual key length is 80 to 256 bits. A sender and receiver must share a secret key. Faster processing because they use the simple mathematical operations. Okay. These are the example. Like 3-, we have that kind of encryption mechanism for that. That asymmetric encryption means we use one key for encryption and other key for decryption. Okay, so that is the asymmetric encryption. Two separate keys which are not shared. So generally what happens that all the big organization or all the certified authorities, they have a two kind of keys. Let me show you something. If I'll open Google, okay. Still loading. Certificate. If I'll see the certificate, okay. I'll go into the details. That these certificates are the asymmetric key encryption. Okay, so I'll want to show you the key here. It's valid. This is the public key. See, so in asymmetric encryption we have a two kind of keys. First one is public and second one is private. Okay, so the thing is public key we can share with anyone. Okay, and the private one we keep it secret only with us only. So the thing is, if anything which is encrypted by the public key, who can decrypt? That guy who have the public key, sorry, that private key. So means which whatever we encrypt by using public key, we can only decrypt with the private key. So the thing is, if we send some data, if we type something in Google, if we like try to search anything, that data basically encrypted by using this key. Okay, remember this thing. This is a public key. And the only Google server have the private key. So when he receives that data, he basically decrypt that data and check what kind of information we are looking on that. Okay, remember this thing. That is the asymmetric encryption. Okay. So in IPsec BPN we use a Diffie-Hellman mechanism for asymmetric. This is the algorithm. It is like very complex algo. It takes around millions of years to break. These are the symmetric algorithms like dash 3 dash 4 which we use for encryption. Like if you see symmetric encryption techniques, this is the like blank data, and basically we can encrypting in such a way. Okay. These are the steps for that. These are not like related to BPN. Like this, it's not a like exact document for BPN. This is the like asymmetric environment. Okay, like we are decrypting the data by using this blue key, and we are encrypting data by using blue key, and we are decrypting the data by using red key. Okay. So what is BPN? BPN is a virtual private network, okay, which provides a secure communication over unsecure network. Virtual information within a private network is transported over a public network. Private traffic is encrypted to keep the data confidential. Like this is our corporate network, and this is the internet, and this is the band network. So we have a BPN here. Okay. So if these are the like mobile workers, these are the business partners. Okay. So if they want to access the corporate resources from there, so they connect with our BPN gateway. After that, basically they can access the resources for which they are looking for that. BPN is a layer. In firewall we configure always layer 3 BPN. Okay. So these are the like we have a two kind of BPN: generic routing encapsulation GRE. So it is GRE is not a secure. Okay. To secure the GRE we use IPsec over GRE. Okay. We have one more BPN: multi protocol level switching MPLS. This basically we use in a switching network. This is a part of routing and switching, and this is our security part, main IPsec. Okay. Types of BPN network: we have a remote access BPN, we have a site-to-site BPN. Okay, so we have a basically two kinds of BPN: remote access BPN or site-to-site BPNs. Site-to-site BPN: host sends and receive normal TCP/IP traffic through a BPN gateway. Okay. This is the remote access BPN. These are like remote workers. Okay. So basically they insert the credential in a client. For that we need to install one client. Like in my system, I'll have one BPN client. Okay. This is Cisco AnyConnect. If I want to connect to my office or any office throughout the world, I can just select the location and I can just enter my credential. I will connect through the resources there. Okay. So I'll use this keyword if I want to work from home. VPN client software. Generally Cisco have that client software, but right now we are not using this client. We are using Cisco AnyConnect VPN. Okay. Remember this thing. Cisco IOS SSL VPN. That is the like latest VPN which we use generally. Provide remote access connectivity from any internet enabled host. Uses a web browser and SSL encryption. Delivers two modes of access. So the thing is, and when Cisco launched that SSL VPN, that time they support only client-less VPN, means it supports like few things. only we can access the HTTP web server available in our network or FTP servers. Okay. After they also launch a thin client VPN. This VPN client based on Java applet. So for that we need to install the Java applet in system, and it starts supporting like some TCP and UDP kind of traffic. After that there is also one more VPN, which is a thick client VPN. Okay, thick client, or we can say AnyConnect. Okay, that is the like, so that's support like anything. We can send any type of traffic, TCP, UDP, ICMP, anything inside that tunnel. Cisco product family, like Cisco VPN enabled router. After that, they Cisco PIX 500 series security appliance. Cisco, this is the ASA. Okay, this is the like VPN concentrator device, 300 series concentrators. Okay, so first they have home routers, after they have a VPN concentrator, then they have a ASA. So they PIX firewall and VPN concentrator, they mix and create and basically build a ASA firewall. So basically they get all the PIX functionalities and all the VPN concentrator functionalities. Okay, so I'm done with this slide. Let me I'll have one more PDM. See, VPN is a very tough, okay, if you are going to understand, because I'm also not good in VPN. And when you learn the VPN, you definitely got a new things always. So let me write some thing in here related to IPsec site-to-site VPN. Okay, IPsec site-to-site VPN. First thing, we use the one protocol that which is IPsec protocol. Okay, so IPsec protocol is a combination of IKE and these encryption mechanisms, AES, DES, SHA, that hashing mechanism, MD5, ISACAM. Okay. So like it's a mixture of these protocols. We have IKE version 1 and IKE version 2. Version 1 and version 2. IPsec means IP security. IKE means Internet Key Exchange. Okay. ISACAM means Internet Security Association Key Management Protocol. Okay. That protocol we use for management of keys. The second thing, that VPN have a 9 packet exchange, okay, not 9 packets, it have a like 2 phases. So we have a phase 1,
which also known as a main node. And we have around 6 packets.
Okay. After that, we have also that same phase 1 in aggressive mode. There we have
3 packets.
Okay. Now we have a phase 2. Phase 2 have overall 3 packets. and it works on main mode.
And it works on push mode, okay? Push mode.
Basically, we use AES-3DES encryption mechanism. Remember this thing, okay? These are the
live interpretation.
Use MD5 SHA-1 SHA-128 and 256 hashing mechanism. Okay. The thing is, in basically to encrypt the data which is sending from like head office to branch office, we use a protocol which is ESP. Okay, so ESP, it provides us confidentiality and
integrity, both. Okay. We also have one more protocol, which is AH. It provides only integrity. Okay, so we use always ESP. We don't use this AH. Okay.
So now the thing is, how we can configure? Configuration is a much main part. How we can configure the VPN, okay? So now let me start my configuration. So I'll go in this network. First I'll open my firewalls. I'll give the name, host name, head office, ASA. So I'll use 10.1.1 network in my inside.
Okay, so I'm talking about the 0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.
exit. I'll use 10.10.network in my IOC. 10.10.10 because
it's like public cloud. I didn't configure the IP, but I'll configure later. Okay, it has 0.255.255.255.0. I'll set the name, which is outside. And set the name, which is 0. Then I run the NoSet command. So I'm just running my technology set. After that, we will start the SQL configuration. So let me also configure my inside IP, which is 10.10.10.250.255.255.0. I also configure on default IP of my internet.
Route outside
0.0.10.10.1. So interface IP degree to verify. My interface is up or not, so it is up right now.
Let me configure other firewall. Okay. country. First, I'll set the name, host name. I'll give the branch office, ASA. Here I am using 10 network. So in branch office, I'll use the 20 network. Okay, here. So I'll go to in my inside interface. Give the name first. Set the IP address. I'll use 20.1.1.250. See, this is my outside. Here I'm using 10.10.10 network. Here I'll use 20.20.20. Okay. Interface GigaGigaSlash0. No start. Name it outside. Secure channel 0. IP address 20.20.20.250.255.255.255.0. And I get one default route.
Route outside 0.0.20.20.20.1. Now let me configure my internet router.
ISP. So I have F0/0 towards ASA1 and F00 towards ASA2. So first I'll pick 0/1, no set, IP address, which is 10.10.10.1.255.255.255.0.
Shit.
Now I'll compare other interface F0/0, no set, IP address 20.20.20.1/255.255.255.0. Let me set the ping to ASAs. Ping set 50. So one ASA is reachable. Let me ping other one. 20.20.20.250. Other one is also reachable. Now let me configure the inside host. F0/0, now set down IP address, which is 10.10.10.255.255.255.0. I'll put one default route 0.0.0.0.0.0.0
and IP address amount 10.10.10.1.1.250.
Let me also set the host name here.
Head office inside. Let me initial that name to get the firewall.
What is the issue? Do so IP interface brief. I'll actually configure the wrong IP address, that's why it's 10.1.1.255.255.0. print 10.0.0. I am able to ping to my firewall. Now let me configure my
branch processing pod user.
No, sir. Branch office. Inside interface of 0/0, set down IP address 20.1.1.100.255.255.255.0. I'll add one default route towards the ASA firewall. I'll initiate the ping, do ping 20.1.1.250. Ping is working, I'm able to reach my
PC.
Okay. So now if I'll ping to my this head office file, head office
inside user. This is 10.1.1.100. I'm not able to ping. Okay. If we configure the VPN between these
devices, that time what happens? This guy able to reach this guy over a public network in a via VPN tunnel. Okay. So now let me start the configuration of my VPN. So in first step, we configure the these are the command crypto. ISACAM policy. Crypto. See, we can configure this ISACAM is, we use that ISACAM keyword in old PSAs like which are running version 8.2. Okay, so we use IKE version 1 here. After we run this, we write this policy. Here we can define the policy between any number. So I'll use 10 here. Okay, see here we have four things. Authentication, encryption, group, hash, and lifetime. These five things. So we need to configure these five things. So authentication. In authentication, we have a PCR and RSA.
RSA signature means we are using the
certificate. But we, in our case, we use PCR. Okay. Authentication, PCR. Encryption. These are the encryption methods. We have a 3DES.
AES 192.
I'll use the AES here. Okay. Now we
also have a hashing. So we use the hashing like we have some hashing. MD5 star. I'll use that. These are the phase one policies. Okay. We also need to define the Diffie Hellman group. Generally, we use the Diffie Hellman group 2. Okay.
After we define the lifetime.
So we use this keyword 86400. It's a like 20 hours. I'm writing in seconds. Okay. So if we then
write anything, then basically by default it takes this value. Okay. I've done with my phase one policies. Now I write phase 2 policies, okay? Crypto, IPsec, IKEv1. After we define the transform set. Transform set we
use for phase 2 policies. So here we need to define the name of this
welcome set. So I'll use
TSET. Okay. So what kind of like encryption mechanism we want to use? So I'll use this
TSP AES. Okay. And hashing mechanism I want to use this one ESP SA HMAC. So we configure the phase 1 policy and phase 2 policy are done. Okay. Now we configure one access list which is for VPN. Okay. Permit IP. Now we define our host. Okay. That subnet, inside subnet. Means here in this Excel we include all the subnet which are participating in the VPN. Okay, if we have 10 subnet we can include that 10 subnets. Okay, same thing here, if we have a 10 subnet here we include all 10 subnet. That access list also known as a proxy ID or traffic selector. Okay, permit IP. So I am having only one network, so I'll use this 10.1.0.255.255.255.0. So here I am, this is my local network. I also need to define my
remote
subnet. Okay. So in remote subnet I am using this, I am having this one, right? 10.1.1.0 and the network 255.255.255.0.
So we check our access list. So an access list. This is our access list. Okay. So we are done with our access list. Okay.
Now we configure one tunnel group. In tunnel group. Now here you need to define the name. So now what happens, we are just creating VPN tunnel between this ASA and this ASA, right? So we use this public network, public IP address, okay? That outside interface IP address is a public IP address, this one, okay? Same here. So in tunnel name, we define the IP address of the peer, other peers, okay? Remote peer. So the other peer having IP address which is 20.20.20.250. After we define the type, IPsec,
L2N, done. Now if I again go here, now I'll run the questionnaire also. So now I want to go into the IPsec attribute. Enter. That will be defined as preset key.
IG V1
preset key. So I am using this preset key now. So 1, 2, 3. This is a confidential. So this must be same on both tiers. And then from here. Now I create a crypto map. I'll give the name to this one as VPN. After I
define the number, so I'll take the 10 here. Okay. Now I want to configure these two things. So in match, I'll call my access list match address. After that,
I'll write the name of my access list, which is VPN.
So run crypto.
Let me go. Crypto.
Crypto. Map I'll give the name to VPN. After that, I define the number. I'll use this
key. Your net address and the name of my actor, which is VPN. Now I again get into that place. Now I'll get into set keyword. Okay. In set keyword, first I'll call my tier. Okay. In tier. I need to define the
public IP address of the remote peer. Okay. Set peer, I'll give the public IP of this guy 250. Now I
again go into the set. I version 1. Transform set, I'll give that name of my transform set. This is T set. Okay, now I am just going to apply this cryptomap. Okay, so here I'll just give the name of interface and I'm applying it in outer interface. The next task, I need to enable the crypto, that VPN crypto I'll given enable on outside. That is the like command which we use. So if I run the history here, so history. And
these are the like commands to configure VPN. Okay. Now, if you want to configure the same VPN in other end, so do one thing. I usually prefer this way. I'll just go to in my branch firewall. So I'll copy this thing. Okay. I'll just copy Control C and I just paste over there. So now my policy is configured. If I run this command, so run crypto. See, my policy is configured now. Okay, that is the best way. Now I'll copy this one. So my phase to policy is configured. Now what happens? I need to change something in my access list, right? So this is the source and this is the destination. When we are configuring VPN in this guy, so this is the source when and this is the destination, right? And now we are configuring the VPN on this ASA. So the source is this network and destination is this network. So what happens, we just copy this part and put this part here. Now our ACL is ready. It's a like mirror image. I'll check that ACL is available now. I'll have an access list, right? Now I need to create this tunnel group. Okay, so in tunnel group, what happens? This is my config. So what I need to change this. This is this network, this public IP, because I need to put the head office ASA public IP, so which is 10.10.10.250. After that, type IPsec.
Well, here. Same thing here. 10.10.10.250. The key is an encrypted content. I'll just write the key 123. And I'll just copy this thing and paste.
And do that. Now we need to configure the
cryptomap.
So in cryptomap, this thing is correct. We need to change this one 10.10.250. This thing is same. This thing is same. This thing is same. So I'll just copy and paste in my other DSA. These are the verification commands. So crypto isacam SA. To see the
Facebook. Right now so what happens when we configure the DPN, we always need to initiate the
traffic. Then only that tunnel comes up. That is the command to see phase 2 tunnel. Crypto IPsec SA.
Right now I don't have any access. So if I will go to my RAM process inside host, now if I initiate the ping to the head office, whether it is counted as 10 or let's suppose 100, so now my ping is working, right? So if I check my access,
it's like head office. I am pinging the same guy, that's why. Where is the branch office? Yeah, that is the branch office. Okay, ping 10.101.108. The repeat count of 100. See, now ping is working. If you want to see, if I run the debug IP ICMP, you are seeing these packets in debugging, right?
So my ping is working. If I
check the assays now, I'll have one assay, right? Write B1, active assay is 1. This is the peer. This is the ASA, second ASA, right? So it have a peer, which is the peer IP is 10.101.250 IP address of this ASA. Okay. This is the type of tunnel. This is the role. This guy is initiated now. And the state is main mode active. Means phase 1 is active now. Now let me also check my phase 2. So crypto IPsec ASA. So here basically you got lots of information, okay, but the main information is you can, if you run this command,
the main information is this one.
This is the packet which is encapsulated, these are the packet which is encrypted, and these are the packet which is hashed or digest, okay. So if how we can only see this information, we use this one. Include, I'll forget the exact command for that. In caps, okay. What I run, so we can include in caps. So it gives us only
this information, okay. So how we can verify our beacon is working enough? If I run
again here, see I am
sending 100 packets. Okay,
again. So let's complete the that ping. I want to show you something here. If you check there, see right now we have an encapsulation which is 199. Now it becomes 299. See. Means there is no any drop with the packets. Okay, so that is the like verification commands for that. We also have some more commands. These are the so crypto IB2 agreement sessions, not session something, yeah, it. Okay, these are the commands. Generally, we can use script.
IPsec. You can say the state for IPsec as well. Okay. It gives a reply, replay features, authenticated, these kind of messages. Okay. The main command is socket to IPsec SA and socket to IsecNet SA. So this is the like VPN, how we can configure the IPsec
site to site VPN in the routers and the firewalls. In the firewalls only, okay. In routers, the command is same. They have like little bit changes only. With that, but nobody using that thing in routers. Everyone use the that VPN in the firewalls always. Okay. So if you have anyone on any question on that, please ask me. Everyone is cleared or everyone got nothing. See, my objective is only to configuration part. Only if you got the SA, how you can configure the VPN. Okay, forget about the theory, because the thing is VPN is a like very big topic. If you say, let me show you some VPN materials to you, if I'll have, because it's like huge. VPN is a very, very broad topics. Okay. All CCI is based on VPNs only, because we have around five, six types of VPNs, but generally we use this IPsec a lot in the network. So if we start teaching VPN, then it takes hardly 1 month. If you want to learn that VPN, I will share you that details of VPNs with the videos as well. Okay, so let me first stop the recording.